You'll notice that the trail arm is actually above the lead arm.
Yeah.
Okay, which is going to be a great sign that that's going to be in good condition. If we were actually a little more flat in the shoulders this way, the trail arm gets underneath really early and that club face gets back open.
So let's talk about the takeaway position. And this video, we're going to talk specifically about club face orientation. Or if you guys at home, this angle of the club face relative as a checkpoint to our spine angle in the takeaway. Now, very often kind of tying in with one of the other videos that we've just done is like the flat shoulder turn. And then as a result, the arms roll away.
That's it.
When we look at that club face, Richard, what would you say about that?
Is drastically open right now, right? Yeah, and I guess the problem is with us as human beings, we're going to react to that some point between that point and back here at impact. We're going to make some compensations, right, to get it back to a playable position or semi-playable.
Yeah, okay. So there's a variety of drills out there. Now, one of the biggest, I suppose, faults that I see with players when they're working on the takeaway is they get way too tense and tight and process driven when they're working on their takeaway to the point where they go like this and they can't even move, right? So as much as we do want to work on the takeaway, guys, it's all also about ensuring that it is staying relatively relaxed within reason and we're breathing and we're getting ourselves into a position where we're not straining anything.
Exactly. From an address point of view, I love what you're just saying there. When I get the players into address, it wants to be the sensation of set the diaphragm really nice and deep, let the arms hang heavy, hang long. Taking the tension out of the elbows, out of the wrist section, grip the club with your normal grip tension, but just let the arms hang long.
Yeah. An important side note for this one is that the arms stay long throughout the swing due to the fact of the weight of the golf club and the movement of the body, not because you're trying to keep them long.
Exactly right. So we're not trying to keep the arms straight. We're not trying to lock them up. It's definitely passive through the joints, long, long arms hanging underneath the shoulders.
Okay, great. So then let's move on to this takeaway position and getting rid of that for the golfer. Let's say they're in their address, a little pump in the elbows just to soften things up. Now from here, what would you recommend that we do to kind of remove that rolling of the forearm and ensuring that this face is matching more so our spine angle?
This is pretty straightforward. What we're going to do, we're going to go back to address for me, Kerrod. And the sensation is going to be that if you actually allowed that trail shoulder to turn up behind the base of your neck, when you do that, you're going to feel like your glove hand is now actually orientated. Almost the knuckles of your glove hand are pointing down toward the turf. Mm. And as a reference point for everybody out there, the lead edge of the club face is now somewhat actually on the same actual angle as your spine angle here. And the club head's somewhat in line with the handle.
Yeah. And just as a little kind of checkpoint and feel for players at home, sometimes the actual front bend of the golf posture and playing a ball on the ground kind of gets players a little bit out of whack.
Yeah.
A great reference is if you stand up and your club face is straight and you simply just do what Richard said, but from a horizontal plane, and we look at that and that club face is straight up and down.
Yeah.
And then I actually increase my front bend like this, well then bang, exactly in that position.
I love that. And it's just to add one little bit to that, if you do that one more time for me, work down, add your forward bend. You'll notice that the trail arm is actually above the lead arm.
Yeah.
Okay, which is going to be a great sign that that's going to be in good condition. If we were actually a little more flat in the shoulders this way, the trail arm gets underneath really early and that club face gets back open.
And we often talk about the follow-on effect of things as well. Like I feel that as soon as you move me into that new position, which wasn't as proficient as the other, like my knee started to do something funky, my weight shifted out there, and then that's where those compensations come in, meaning that this first section of the takeaway is so important.
100%, absolutely.
Okay, so setting up here, arms are nice and soft, and then from there, I'm feeling like my trail shoulder, which I love. So trail shoulder's moving behind my neck, you said?
Yeah, up behind the base of your neck.
Yep, into that position there. Club face, as you can see, is matching.
Absolutely.
Now, we get a few things for free as we do this. Like number one, another checkpoint is the club and the hands are relatively in line and they're also relatively pointing at the target as well.
100% they are, absolutely. So everything's orientated down towards that target line.
Mm. And then one other thing that I really, really like about this is when you put in an internal focus on this trail shoulder, moving behind you, even though this is the element that we're trying to adjust, we shouldn't actually focus too much on this itself, but this moves at an effect to the cause of moving the body correctly, because we see too many players go, okay, let's get the club face matching the spine angle.
Exactly.
Then all that, yeah, like, okay, well, great, yeah. But that doesn't really blend into anything.
There's just having that harmony between both, right? The internal focus of what the body's doing and the external focus of where the club face is.
Yeah, great. So as I get this movement of this trail shoulder behind my neck, I pivot, 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 arms are nice and soft. We can actually see that my right arm has stayed long naturally, long, not tense,
yep.
Due to the fact that I focused on turning my back shoulder behind my neck. Club face is in a good orientation. Now, talk about the benefits of doing this in regards to the initial sort of idea that we were talking about, where it fixes the head moving off and sure the club does. Moving yeah. behind.
Yeah, so most golfers or a lot of amateur players, when they do get, for a term, that flat shoulder look through the early part of the backswing, the right arm, so if we go into that flat position this way, the right arm bends a lot early. We lose the rotation of the trunk or the thorax. Arm swing gets really narrow, loss of power, loss of accuracy. So that sense of having width in the backswing is going to be a byproduct of the rotation and tilt that the trunk and the pelvis makes. Okay, and then in conjunction with where the club face is, if we get too linear or too lateral this way, okay, the right arm bends a little early, gets narrow, arm swing gets long, body turn gets short, loss of power.
Yeah, so I think kind of putting a bow on this for everyone is that maybe one of the best, sequences of feels that they could get for their takeaway, combining the great knowledge that you've just shared there and also a little bit of this relaxing component that I was suggesting before we got into it, is more so from the address position, feeling the arms are long and soft, and then trail shoulder as you're breathing is kind of moving behind your yeah. body. And before you know it, right, we can see that the hands are in front. You were talking off camera before we started about if your hands are here, and we can see that my thumbs are relatively in front of my shoulders, getting that same feeling that they're just moving back as a big unit here.
Absolutely. So you really see that your arms are really located in front of your rib cage. The trail palms facing towards the target line, the outside of the lead hands facing down towards the target line. A really simple way of getting that sensation where you want to be in the early part of the backswing.
Love it, love it. All right, so I'm going to do a little practice swing of that and then I'm going to show one down there for us. So feeling nice and relaxed, trail shoulder moves behind, feeling like the hands are in front. That looks great.
Love it.
I reckon we're in a good spot together, in a nice shot here. You know what?
Watched it.
Exactly at the target. Good job.
Good job, man. Great job.